Curiosity, adventure, and love. Three motivations at the heart of a documentary film by the same name. They are also the three attributes that saw 18-year-old American Jessie Josephine Co. Lichauco through a colorful journey from America to Philippine shores after she accepted the proposal of love. Also woven from three threads, the film is a brainchild of Manila-based freelance journalist Sunshine Lichauco De Leon and U.S.-based filmmaker Suzanne Richardon. A film that took 7 years in the making, the film immortalizes Lichauco's vivid memories of life on the big screen. It won the Special Jury Prize in the Filipino New Cinema category of the 2016 World Premieres Film Festival Philippines. It has also been selected to be part of the exhibition at the Cinemalaya Festival in Manila, running until August 14.
All right, and with us this morning, our first guest for Hot Copy is Sunshine De Leon. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming to Head Start.
Thank you so much for
so
having
first,
me.
So first, I mean, are you excited? I mean, clearly you finished this film. It's 7 years in the making. How do you feel?
I'm not sure there is a word to describe how I feel. I feel everything. I feel all happy, positive, excited emotions.
Okay.
I mean, there's just so much to look forward to, and there's been so many great things that have happened since finishing the film.
Yeah.
It was beyond anything I could have ever imagined.
Why did you think of doing this film?
It's funny, because I think back now, and I don't remember a time when I didn't think of doing the film. I've had it in my gut for so long.
Yeah.
It started because when my grandmother's gift is her memory. She remembers everything, and she remembers it with clarity and detail. And I used to, growing up, I would see people, I would watch people listen to her stories, and I would see their reactions. And they were always fascinated, and they wanted to know more. And then as I got older and people would come and continue to visit her, I just realized that she was a great character through which to get people interested in the history of the Philippines, which I felt growing up people didn't know enough about, both abroad and here. I think there's so much that she has to share, and I think that you have to understand your history and where you've come from in order to fully understand where you can go in life, as a country, as a person. So I thought that her memories would be the best way to bring that history alive and share it to people on the screen.
Yeah.
And I also thought, you know, I watched her in action. I watched her humanity, her compassion, her I call it Nana's way, her way of living, her way of being, her way of seeing the world. I thought it was very special and unique, and there were a lot of lessons that she offers, simple truths that we often forget, that I also thought would be great to share with people.
How would you define, would you consider this a movie or a documentary? Where would it fall under?
It's a documentary.
Okay.
It's definitely a documentary.
Do you use actors in any part of the film when she tells stories?
No.
Nothing?
No. Everything's real.
All right.
And we have a combination of survivors of the war. We have my grandmother. We have historians. We have people who've known her throughout her life, you know, commenting in different ways to add to the story. It's basically, what we tried to do was blend history, the history of the Philippines, with her own biography, with the third thread. I called it threads that we were weaving together. The third thread was, I call it humanity. It's her wisdom and insights on life, having seen the world grow up.
Yeah.
I mean, she's 104, so she's seen a lot of different things. And it's, what does she want to pass on to us?
Yeah. Now, there's a resurgence of interest in Philippine history, especially when it comes to the younger set, seeing it in more commercial terms. Mm-hmm. I mean, after the success of General Luna, it's paved the way for many people to actually go out, go to the theater, and pay to watch something historical. You know, I mean, it wasn't so many, it wasn't like this 10 years ago. General Luna was, it was a biopic about a figure that has been dead for a long time. It used actors. This particular film of yours, it's a documentary, but what is the goal? What is the theme other than, I mean, clearly she weaves Philippine history together. What did you set out to teach or to tell in the end?
I think that, first of all, about your comment about the resurgence of people wanting to know about history, I was so happy when Teodoro Luna was made, and the reaction was the way it was.
Yeah.
I wrote my co-producer, who was an American, and I said, I think we're on the right track.
I think the people
are starting.
Yeah.
I mean, because I made this film because I always had this gut thing that I should make the film. I never really thought, are people going to like it? How's it going to do, et cetera? So when the audience seemed ready for this kind of thing, I was very excited. The goal is in the title, I think. I wanted to make a film that inspired people to be more curious about each other, about life. I always said that if people saw the film and they suddenly left it with a desire to be more curious, an interest in being more adventurous, however they wanted to define adventure in their life, and look at each other with more compassion and love, then my goal would have been, as a storyteller, I would have served my purpose. On a larger level, I want people to care more about Philippine history. I think it's interesting and misunderstood or not understood at all. And it's so I wanted people to know more about history, and I wanted people to just learn to be inspired by the little things that she does in the story, and to understand that everything has a ripple effect. Small action, the smallest of actions can lead to the greatest of change. It's not hard to change people's lives. It's not hard to help people. You don't need a lot of time or money. You just need to care. And it's a lot of that sort of simple wisdom that reminds us of our, how we can be, that we can always be better than we think.
Is there a misconception in Philippine history that you tackle in this film? Can you tell us what that is without revealing too much?
A misconception?
Yeah, like something you feel that this film addresses?
I don't think that this film necessarily addresses misconceptions. I think it just provides the broad strokes to understand the context of the Filipino country and culture and history. I think, a lot of people in America don't know it was an American colony. A lot of people forget it was a Spanish colony. A lot of people have said to me, oh, I didn't know the Philippines was so devastated during the war. Okay. I think it enlightens people more. It sheds light on things that they might not have known. They didn't know that Manila was so devastated. Things like that.
Okay. You were filming this for 7 years.
Yeah.
7 years is a long time.
Yes.
Tell us, take us through the challenges in the last 7 years. What was, I can imagine just how difficult it was.
Yeah, it was the hardest thing I've ever done in my life.
All right.
And I had no idea when I got into it how hard it was going to be.
So you started funding it with your own money?
Yes.
Okay. Tell us, were you the first camera person?
No, I didn't shoot it.
Okay,
I had my hands in everything except shooting it.
Okay. So what did you do, like, in the first year?
In the first year, originally I thought her story would be a book. And then someone had said to me, the fact that she can speak at 99 and remember things so clearly, forget the book, do a film. So I rather naively said, okay, I'll make a film, having actually no idea what that meant or what that would entail. So I didn't really know what the story was going to be. I knew I had a good story, I just didn't know how to tell it. And I didn't know what to include, what not to include. So I just started to film her. I just hired a crew and said, let's just sit her down and ask her 100,000 questions.
Yeah. And